strongly believe that separation of state and the church, and in this case the separation of the state and any religious community, is essential for the secular state. I understand the role of the state, of the government, in controlling the situation and supporting the harmonious coexistence of diverse groups, but I don't think the state must interfere in relationship of religious communities. There is a wonderful model which functions quite well almost for 10 years already in Georgia. It's a council, religious council, which is functioning in the framework of the Public Defender's Office, and it's kind of though it's within the semi-governmental body, but it's absolutely independent. So we have the relationship with government, and government supports our cooperation, the cooperation of various religious communities, but the government does not interfere in our lives. Georgian society has always been very diverse, ethnic-wise, religious-wise. Various religious groups have lived together for centuries on this land. The story of our coexistence has not always been peaceful. We had conflicts, we had problems with Muslims, though we are very proud of having a Jewish community for centuries without any problems, but still there has always been also a very careful relationship with this particular religious and ethnic group. So I strongly believe that the diversity is a richness of the society, and though it may bear some problems because diverse groups have diverse interests, and they of course may have some disagreements, but if it is led wisely and if it is led if everybody feels that this is our land and we need to take care of this country, then the diversity can even more contribute to building up the society and bring all these wonderful values to the culture. Of course, different religious groups can live in one society. I don't think that the main problem of xenophobia an acceptance of diversities in our society has their sources from the constitution. I don't really think so. We are not the people of the law, and law cannot really control our relationships. I think the main problem is the very poor culture of diversity, very poor culture of tolerance, which is not something that can be carved in stone. Though we have good examples in different parts of our history, but now in current situation, we need to rethink our policy, rethink our understanding of tolerance. So I don't think the problem is coming from the constitutional agreement with the Orthodox Church, though I don't think it's very democratic document. Mm-hmm. What is happening today in our country, our children will be very much embarrassed to read about what happened, for instance, yesterday in Kobuleti. This is something I thought that I would never be surprised after cut down minarets, or after beating up imam in one of the Muslim villages. I thought nothing can really surprise or embarrass me anymore, but yesterday what happened in Kobuleti, when the people of people who identify themselves as Christians. I cannot call them Christians, really. Who identify themselves as Christians, they nailed a head of pig on an educational center of Muslim children. Nothing like this have ever happened in our country. And this is probably the lowest where the situation where the society can find themselves.